and welcome to the Chamber Showcase. I'm Lisa O'Loughlin, producer and host of the show, and once again it gives me great pleasure to bring you information about the Malden Chamber of Commerce and what's happening around the city, and introducing you to some of our members and or activities that are going on. So today my first guest is Jayme Aronson of Fly by the Moon Media. Welcome, Jayme.
Hi. Thank
nice
you so
to
much.
Have you.
Thank you so much.
So you're a new member of the Chamber.
I am.
What made you join?
What made me join? How did I meet John? Oh, I had a random text from a gentleman, a marketing guy within your crew,
mm-hmm.
and I came to one of the events, and I said, oh, wow, this is lovely. New faces, people up to creative lifestyles and such, and people locally, and I said, oh, interesting. Mm-hmm. And I decided to join from there.
Well, it was a good decision on your part, and we're happy to have you. So last month, and frequently, I read a list of new members and recurring members and renewing members, and you were on the list as a new member a full month ago now. And as I came across your name, Fly by the Moon Media, I said to the audience, to the group, what a great name for a company. So how'd you come up with that name?
Yeah, thank you. A dear friend of mine and I were thinking about going into business together, and so we're brainstorming, and we're both huge music fans, and he was starting to sing the Frank Sinatra song, Fly Me to the Moon, dun, 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 dun. So as he said that, I said, I don't want to use the same lyric. I said, what about Fly by the Moon? And we had agreed on that as our name.
Yeah, well, it's a catchy name, and yeah. I do like it.
Thank you.
I don't know, how does it describe your business? So tell me what it is you do.
Yeah, so wedding photographer, videographer. I've been in the industry for 11 years now.
Uh-huh.
So our focus is weddings, events, real estate, and promotional videos.
Okay.
Yeah.
And we enlisted your services as soon as you joined.
Fun.
It was fun.
We had a blast.
You may not know, but the Taste of Malden is my favorite event.
Okay.
I say it, that anybody who watches the show is going to say, here she goes again. But it is my favorite event, partly because I love food, but it's just a great night.
Yeah.
And you get to see a lot of restaurants, a lot of people, and it's just a fun event. So it was your first Taste of Malden, and you did a videography, mm-hmm. is that how you say it?
Video. Films.
Of the night.
Yeah.
So what did you think of the Taste of Malden?
Well, I had a blast. First of all, the vibe was great. New faces, some old faces, so that was great to see that it was an expanded group of people.
Mm-hmm.
Food was awesome. It was very welcoming. The music was great.
Yeah.
And what else did I think? It was warm and friendly, and it felt like home.
Yeah.
Did
you eat a lot?
I ate a plate and a half, I think, and some desserts, and I took some desserts home.
Yeah, okay. I did pretty much the same as well. And like you say, you saw some old faces. Have you been to any other networking groups that we've done yet?
I think there was one or two I went to.
Good.
Yeah.
So I always reiterate the value of networking for members.
Sure.
And I tell, again, our audience, our fellow members, that they really need to take advantage of the opportunity to go out to a networking event. It's a fun night, like it's a social event, but you get to meet others, and you connect that way, and more people will know what you do, and you'll know what other people do, and you might hear of an event that somebody's doing and suggest that you come and video it for them.
Totally.
Or whatever. So it's really very valuable, you know? So are you from this area?
Not originally, no. I am from the North Shore area, so Malden is close to where I grew up, yeah, for sure.
It's a happening town.
It is. It's shifted a lot. Both of my parents were from Malden originally, and so it's different from back then, and yet it's much more eclectic now, so it's really, it's intriguing.
Yeah. Any restaurant from any country of any meal. Is for, you know, one. And of course you can't appreciate City Hall coming down if you didn't grow up here.
Yeah, I remember that. Yeah.
So of course locals are very happy about that. It opens up Pleasant Street right where we are at MATV. You can go straight out now, and whereas when I grew up it was open.
Yeah.
But they closed it off, I think, in the 70s with that City Hall. So
interesting.
It's very exciting to have it reopened. And the mayor's been my guest. He keeps us informed, you know, of what's happening and when they're going to be moving in. And again, a lot of apartments going up, a lot of people moving in. We got the T right here. There's a lot to say and do in and around Malden. Have you been to any of the game rooms?
It's super exciting.
Or anything?
Yet? I haven't yet. I'm a huge fan of hiking in the Fellsway. I live right over on the west end of Malden is where I reside.
Yeah.
And so the Fellsway is right there. A gold mine it is.
It is. It really is. People don't appreciate the natural resource of all of that. Mm-hmm. And one of our members on a smaller scale, the Friend of the Fells, you know, they were doing a lantern walk. It's up on our website.
Oh, wow,
if
incredible.
Anybody should go to the website, and I encourage everybody to go to the website.
There's go to the website.
There's always a wealth of information. Yeah, go to the website.
Go to the website.
And there's like a lantern walk coming up around Fellsmere Pond.
Yay. So, I will look that up. Thank you.
And then Friends of the Fells do some special tours up by the Waterhouse, you know, on the Stoneham, Malden, Medford line.
Okay.
Over by, well, the old hospital, you might not know. But anyway, there's just lots going on, and hiking is.
Yeah, it's a diverse area with diverse things to do, which is really, really appealing to a plethora of people of all ages, too, which is really, it's nice. It's nice to have the young, the middle, the old, the elder.
Right.
You can
all
you know,
grouped in there. In fact, our Markey Center, I almost called it the Senior Center because in the old days we called it the Senior Center, and they've done away with that name now, and it's really a mixed bag. Karen Hayes, the director of the center, is really Health and Human Services for the city.
Okay.
So she deals with youth and older folks, and she can combine them, which is beneficial for both groups. You know, you learn from your elders, and the elders get learned from the new ones, and so it makes for a great win-win. But back to Fly by the Moon. So you did your show. Now, did you have to tape a lot of it and then cut it and edit it to the final product?
I did cut and edit little clips here and there, whatever felt like this magnetic pull. That's how I shoot. I get into this zone, and it's like this magnetism towards whatever is alive and thrilling and exciting.
Well, I thought the whole video was, and in fact, if you like, we can show it. We'll see it here, and our viewers will watch it. So join us to watch the video filmed by Fly by the Moon Media at the Taste of Malden 2019, our 10th anniversary, by the way.
Mm.
Come back and join us after, and we'll talk a little bit more.
Thank you.
just got to enjoy the video of Taste of Malden, done by our own very special guest, Jayme here. It was a great video.
Thank you.
How'd you pick the music for it?
I think I put upbeat, something upbeat, fun music, and there was a few different tracks, and I said, that one, because it got me dancing.
Yeah.
So then I was just, picking out different scenes and putting it to the music, and I'm dancing and smiling while I'm editing, which is one of the things I love to do.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah. And you and I both, as we were watching, I'll have to admit, I'll speak for myself only, I'm like, I want a bite of that. Oh, I need some more of that.
But sure.
It was good food, and we both commented on bikini, those little desserts,
yes.
And everything was over the top, though. I don't want to pick any one out. But it was really a great night. So what's your next project? Do you have anything going right now?
Oh, boy, what is my next project? Ooh, to do, to do, to do, to do, to do. What is my next project? There's a local business, a scooter company, that is interested in a promotional video. So that's going to be fun to film. I'll get to maybe scoot next to him with a video camera. Ooh. And that and a wedding coming up this weekend.
Uh-huh.
And, oh gosh, I'm embarking on a film career, so I'm actually in the process of drafting up a treatment for a documentary that we'll be filming within the next few months.
Really? Good for you.
Yeah.
So you're busy.
I'm busy.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, that's great. You're going to find time to come to the next chamber event?
When is it?
Well, we have our big bowling marathon, which is our second guest, and we'll be talking about that, so I don't want to sort of steal the thunder from the next guest, but it's a really fun night, even if you don't want to bowl.
Okay. I want to bowl.
Well, so you can get a team or ask Joan to find somebody that needs you on a team.
I love that.
And it's a real fun night. And if you stay in here, I'll talk much more about it.
Got it.
As the time goes on. We just had a networking the other night, which I'm also going to talk to Joan about. And they come up quite regularly.
Great.
And I really do encourage it. Our last one, too, was, there was one last week, but before that, we were at Hugh O'Neill. So Hugh was at, his name isn't Hugh, I call him Hugh. But anyway, Shane was at the Taste of Malden, and he did a networking at his restaurant for all of us, and it was a huge successful night.
Awesome. I heard there's something on the 12th, the gallery, I believe.
Oh, okay.
I think so. That was the next one on my calendar.
Okay.
But I'll look forward to the bowling one. I'll make sure I get that information.
Yeah,
I want to play.
And you and for all of our listening as well, I just repeat myself regularly, but please do visit the Chamber website. We have a nice newsletter that Joan sends out. There's always a list of events. You can post jobs. You can look for a job. It's just a great resource, and I don't think enough of our members, as well as our citizens at large, take advantage of the chamber. So with that, I'm going to say goodbye to Jayme. And
thank you
very much for coming on the show.
Thank you.
We'll
Lisa.
See you again.
Yes.
And I'll keep you in mind, too, if we have something going on that we could have videoed and put on the Chamber Showcase.
I'd love to.
So stick with us. We'll
thank
be
you.
Back after a PSA and with my second guest. Chamber Showcase Part 2, and with me is my second guest and also the executive director of the chamber herself, Joan Ford, Mangeau, how are you?
I'm well, Lisa, thank you.
We chat all the time, but this is more of a formal situation.
Yes.
So you saw the video. I mean, I know you saw it before anyway, but we just showed her on the first segment. It was awesome.
It was terrific, and I think it really captured the spirit of Taste of Malden.
Yeah.
Jayme did a great job.
She did. And just seeing all the people and all their food again, as I said to Jayme, it makes me want to go eat some more.
Me too.
Because it was great. So that's past.
Yes.
As is, I mentioned Hugh O'Neill's. We had a networking event there not too long ago.
That's
huge
right.
Huge success.
Mm-hmm.
And you heard me say how I think how valuable networking is.
Mm-hmm.
Anything you want to add to that?
We had a tremendous networking event last week at Marty's Furniture, which was in Malden, in Melrose, sorry. But both Malden and Melrose claim Marty's Furniture as their member.
Yep.
So it was a combined event with Melrose, and we had a guest speaker who read from, she's a motivational speaker, and she read from her most recent book. Plus, there was a lot of networking,
yes,
and it was nice to meet people from the other chamber.
Mm-hmm.
And I think everybody got along really well, and I think people were very interested in what everybody in the room was doing.
Sure.
So it was a very nice vibe in the room.
And full disclosure, you were the former executive director of Melrose. I am a member of both.
Yes, that's true.
As many are. Marty is a good example. Many of us belong to several chambers because of the importance and the value there is to that.
Exactly. And I tell everybody, you don't need a passport to go to Melrose. Mm-hmm.
And let's face it, Joan, it's what, 20 feet over the line?
It is, literally.
I mean,
right.
It might be 30 feet, but it's right on the Malden
exactly.
line. So
exactly.
Exactly. And I was there, and it was great. And her book was quite interesting. She did read from it.
Yes.
I was going to speak with her afterwards, but the line was too long. So I went back and drank more free champagne
there
from
you go.
Another member that donated, you know, a nice champagne. And,
right.
You know, nice little nosh to nibble and on and on.
It
so,
was.
Yeah.
And it was a beautiful location, a lot of wonderful spirit in the room.
Mm-hmm.
And John Taza and his family always roll out the red carpet for anybody who comes into the showroom at Marty's Furniture.
Right. So those are the past things that have been going
yes.
on. Now what's coming up? Hint, hint,
now
hint.
What's coming up is the 4th annual Super Bowl, which personally is one of my favorites. Actually, all my events are my favorites for different reasons.
Yeah.
This particular one I really like because there's healthy competition, there's a lot of friendship, and there's a lot of fun. You don't have to bowl to be a part of it. You just have to want to go and participate and network and have fun with your peer chamber members.
Mm-hmm.
So we can have up to 48 teams of 5 players each. Anthony Dakotas donates all the lanes at Town Line Luxury Lanes. And for $225, each team gets a pair of shoes and 2 hours of bowling.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a load of fun. And at the end of the night, there is a high score trophy, a low score, I guess they call it a gutter ball trophy, and a most spirited trophy. So there's a lot of, like I said, healthy competition going on, whether it's for the high, the low, or the most spirited.
Now, is the most spirited part of the costume part?
It is.
So
part,
we
yes.
Should, yeah, just
we
mention
encourage,
that a little bit.
We encourage people to dress up. Some people are not comfortable doing that. That's totally fine.
Mm-hmm.
But last year, for example, we had Encore Boston Harbor there, and they all dressed like decks of cards.
Uh-huh.
So they were very, very creative. Cataldo Ambulance dressed like clowns. And just use your imagination.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't have
mm-hmm.
to have anything to do with your business.
No.
Just have fun with it.
So in my former job, I attended that, and I got my fellow nurses to come, and we did not want to dress as nurses, which could have been fun, or, you know,
that
doctors.
That could have been fun.
But we dressed as superwomen.
There you
so
go.
So we were Supergirl and Batgirl and every one of them, and we sent away for the sheets and, you know, the tops, rather, and the different masks and everything like that. So, but you know who won that year was the City Hall folks. They were dressed as bees.
Oh, Burt's, yes. The MRA folks, yes.
Yeah. And they were really
I've
cute.
I've heard about
and
that.
And they had the Burt's lip balm to hand out. Burt's
That's an adorable idea.
Yeah.
That's before
she
my
won.
Time.
Yeah,
but
she
that's
won.
Pretty clever.
Yeah, that's right.
But I think people go to this to simply have fun.
Yeah.
It's a great night out.
Yeah.
And the after party's even more fun.
Mm-hmm.
So
it is
just a really nice way to celebrate, to start summer.
Yeah.
And one of the great things about this, as with all of our major events, we are going to give a portion of our proceeds to two different organizations in Malden this year. $25 from each team will go to the Arlene Goldstein Cepitelli Scholarship, which was established by the Malden High School class of 1982. Okay. So each team that signs up, $25 of their registration fee will go toward the scholarship fund. And then a portion of the evening's proceeds will go to the Chinese Cultural Connection.
Oh, nice.
Yes. Yeah. So it's also giving back.
Sure. Well, the Chamber always does. I've mentioned always. Many times on the show here that when the Chamber does any event, the Taste of Malden being mm-hmm. a great example, we supported the food security program for
at the
YMCA, the young mm-hmm. kids, for the summer. And to do Chinese Cultural Connection. We've done Bread of Life before. We've
sure.
done Housing Families before. So
we've done Triangle.
Triangle.
So I think that there are plenty of organizations in the city that could use a little help, mm-hmm. use a little exposure. Mm-hmm. And I think that it's a great way to show our support for these not-for-profits.
Mm-hmm. Right. So do you want to speak to the audience a little bit,
sure.
our viewers, and,
sure.
and let them know where your office is and
oh,
how
sure,
to access you?
Oh, sure. My office is at 2 Maplewood Street. Feel free to come by, although I must warn you, I'm sometimes out of the office because I might be out visiting my members. So best way to reach me is email me first, director@maldenchamber.org. And I will meet you anywhere, anytime, any place. So if you just give me a heads up, I will make a point of meeting you.
And I think that's important, too, because a lot of our chamber members aren't actively involved. And if
yes.
they would just do it once, you'd hook, line, and sink.
Absolutely.
Right
I've noticed that.
Yeah.
And I think people just want to be engaged.
Yeah.
People want to be asked. And I think that it's important because the Chamber of Commerce is not just a Chamber of Commerce. It's a chamber of community. And we have to keep that in mind. And we're all part of the same community. We're all working towards similar goals. So I think that that is really important, certainly for me to remember mm-hmm. every day.
Yeah. And it's nice, too, the connection with the government, with the city.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Without the city's support, we would just be floating.
Yeah, but on the other, it reverses too.
Absolutely.
I mean, they invite you to the table. They want to hear.
Absolutely.
Because it's
One of my biggest jobs is advocacy.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
if we have a business that's got a question, if we have a business that has an issue, they'll often contact me first.
Mm-hmm.
And then I can bring it to the right people in City Hall.
Yeah.
So they don't have to scratch their head and say, oh, who should I talk to
yeah.
about this?
Yeah.
I typically would know. So that is one of the real benefits to being a chamber member.
Mm-hmm. And I know that you'll attend all of the ribbon cuttings, whether they're a member or not. You'll
I
still
do.
Go to their ribbon cutting.
I do, because that's a real yeah. sign of how the city is flourishing,
mm-hmm.
how the city is developing. So I think ribbon cuttings are just an amazing symbol
mm-hmm.
of how dynamic the city
yeah.
is.
And it's a changing city. I was talking with
mm-hmm.
Jayme how much
mm-hmm.
the city has changed over the last few years.
Yes.
It's incredible.
Oh, absolutely.
So, yeah.
I lived here back when I was first married, which was the Stone Age, and it has changed tremendously
yeah.
since then.
Yeah. Well, you know, Jordan Shapiro, one of our board members,
yes.
local attorney, Jordan often talks about the old days, and I kind of smirk because I'm older than you, and not as old as Jordan, but I do remember the Jordan Marsh. And the
I remember Jordan Marsh, yes.
And the women's,
yes.
You know, the
Lady Grace
stores, Lady Grace, yeah, and Boston Leader.
Yes.
And, the 5 and 10s, of course, you'd go get
sure.
your 10-cent popcorn this big
absolutely.
And cross over to watch the movie.
Growing up in Melrose, Malden was a destination.
It was. Melrose had nothing.
We had nothing.
And we had a bus.
We had a bus.
5-cent bus or
and
a 10-cent bus.
It was okay with Mom and Dad
yeah.
that I actually got on a bus and went to Malden
yeah.
as opposed to getting on the T and going it to Boston.
Well, there you go.
So
yeah. So you've watched Malden change from
I have.
Those years
I
as
have.
Well.
I have, absolutely.
Yeah. So it's
but it's all for the good.
Yes, it is. It is. And my biggest difficulty, I think, is deciding what restaurant to go to.
Oh, me too.
Because there's so many good ones.
Me too.
And seeing that video again on...
I'm hungry.
Yeah, really. I'm thinking, do I want to go here? Do I want to
yeah.
go there? And So it just makes it feel really good. So what else is going on with the Chamber? Anything new to report?
Sure. Well, in July, we'll have our Year of Dining raffle, which I think you won last year, Lisa.
Which is why I love to eat. Can you tell? I know, I did.
So that will be a raffle that will be held the end of July, and it will be 52 gift cards to restaurants in Malden.
So can I just say to anybody who's watching the show, yes, I did win. I'm a little embarrassed. But
you weren't on the board yet.
But you know what was interesting? You may not know this, and I've said it before. I had left the city. I retired from my job, moved away, well, moved back home, and then came back. And the first meeting that I went to back as a member of the chamber was there.
Mm-hmm.
And it was the night of the pull.
Yes.
And I thought, oh, I'm back. I got to buy a ticket.
Sure.
So I bought it like an hour before you did the draw.
One ticket.
And I know you shook it good.
I did. I never expected. Yeah.
But it's fun. Because,
yes,
like you say, it's 52 weeks and a good 25, 30 restaurants maybe, or eateries, not just restaurants. Other
Precisely.
Things. Yeah.
It could be bakeries, coffee shops, things like that as well.
Yeah.
But I find that last year, everybody wanted to participate because if you get a $25 gift card to one of our local restaurants, mm-hmm, you're going to go in and spend way more than $25.
Oh, we do. I don't know how much of a bargain it was winning, but I go anyway.
They're going to hook you.
Yeah.
You know, you walk through the door once. These restaurants are so wonderful.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to get you right in there. So it's a wonderful introduction to our restaurants.
No, it is. As is the taste.
Oh,
a
the
lot
taste
of people
is.
Aren't
oh,
familiar, so they go to the Taste of Malden and they say, I got to go back and try this one out.
Yes.
So, again, it's just a great opportunity. So buy a ticket. $10?
$10.
$10.
And they will be on our website. You will be able to buy them using PayPal.
Okay.
Or you can email me. And I deliver, so we will make sure that you get your ticket if you want it.
Okay.
So, and it's a great event.
Yeah.
So,
and it's a good fundraiser.
It is a very good fundraiser, and it shines a light on some of our amazing restaurants. Mm-hmm. So
that's in July.
That is
now is
the
that
end
at
of
a
July.
Special
it
event.
It will
meeting?
Be at a special event. Mm-hmm. We have yet to determine exactly where, though.
Okay.
Yes.
Well, we'll stay. So my June. Meeting my June chamber showcase will be right after the bowl-a-thon, so we'll have to have a guest come in to talk about how it was and if we have any photos or videos. Do you have any pictures from last year that
we
can show up
I
there?
I do. I think Guillermo.
So I don't know if we can get some photos up there, or we just put them in at the end of last year's bowling. Here we go.
There we go. There's the Cataldo group.
Yeah.
Oh, they were the Hawaiian theme. Oh, that's Century Bank. They actually won Most Spirited last year.
Wrap it up.
There's the Encore Boston Harbor Group. Oh, there I am presenting the trophy to Louis Barreto of L&L Services, who seems to win every year,
mm-hmm,
as myth has it. These are some more of our teams. So it's a good group. It's
it
a
is.
Fun night.
That's great. So we're going to wrap up the show.
Great.
And thanks for coming on.
Thank you,
good
Lisa.
Good luck at the bowl-a-thon. I will be there.
Good.
And whether I'm with a team or not, I don't know yet.
Well,
but I'll see you there.
I can
and
always
I'll see
find
you
a team if you want.
All right.
All right.
Good.
Thank
thanks,
you.
Joan. And there's another show, Chamber Showcase, that we're wrapping up. Be well, be safe, and be kind. We'll see you next month. Bye-bye.